What's up and welcome. Today I'm drawing some big, well, yesterday I was drawing some big brains for this area. Spoiler alert, by the way. This is a big old spoiler alert. This whole stream is a spoiler. I'm working on the final cutscenes today. So, I'm working on a cutscene now where this brain over here, this hemisphere, will activate. So it's right after you beat the final boss. It's like a cutscene where the lightning boss is going to appear. She gives the ship energy to the left brain. The left brain activates, and then that's it for the cutscene. So yeah, that's the goal for right now. Okay, so I want to go to the screen where you're fighting the last boss. Which is this one. Okay, and the foe, don't even fight Metatron, so it just immediately triggers the last event, which right now should trigger this other cutscene, which happens after this, where this, the ship starts moving and stuff. Yeah, right here. It's a really crazy cut. It's not, that part's not working. But yeah, this is where the ship or the tower will start. It's way too many pixels right there. It's like, but yeah, it'll start rising into the air. Okay, so I want to work on that cutscene there, and that's gonna be in story. And this is like Tower Rising, but then it's a lot like the other one, which is Shipfall. Oh, it's just that, an M Segway ship engine. Okay, so I've already got an item called Ending. We're going to use that ending item to track the progress through through the ending cutscenes. So let's make sure that is all set correctly. We know we have an, I know I have an item ending, but is it all set up right? Right, it doesn't count, that's good. Oh, but it also can be going up to 2. So 0 indicates that the ending is not even started. 1 means it's started. 2 means it's further along. That part will be determined, I guess. Okay, so it's a lot like this where you get these items and stuff. Let's just copy this whole thing. Okay, so you get item ending here. We segue to the tower preview. No, tower brain. We delay for however long that segue is going to take. Start with 13 seconds, 10 seconds maybe. And then we do cutscene, tower rising, another delay, shake, and start a countdown. Okay, so segue to tower brain, that part of the story. Gotta go to the story system and make sure that is gonna work. Here's segue. It looks for the pattern, but I think it looks for it only in the current Z. So we need to loop over, well, I guess we can start with Z. I is better. Okay, I is zero. I is less than K world num tunnels. I guess max dungeon tunnels. All right, that's comes Z. So segue, we're gonna look through all the levels. Oh. No, this is actually extra levels. Num extra Z per level, that's it. Okay, so there. It's basically looping over all the extra possible Zs. It starts with the current Z and then gets whatever that Z is for each level. It starts with Z. If I is zero, the first index uses just the Z. Otherwise, it uses the extra Z. So it goes through basically every possible floor of the current dungeon and looks for the pattern that it's looking for until it finds it, and then it does it. So that should make it so that it can do this segue. It can find the actual room no matter what floor it's on. And it probably is worth it to set a breakpoint here to make sure this actually works, so I didn't break the other segue. And this segue works as well. So I'm gonna open up Xcode, set a breakpoint, make sure this actually gets hit. It functions as it should. And then we'll have the segue ready to go. Looks like it didn't work at all. Ah, okay, I must have typed something wrong or make sure that story verbosity is on. It'll make today's coding much easier. All right, so it's running it. Oh, there, it just had to wait longer. So the first Z is 99. Oh, that's not what I meant. What's this Z? Oh, okay. So the Z you want to start with is actually constants get level Z. Ah, there's too much delay then. There, let's get this ship shape. Oh, there's 3 second delay. Gives you ending. Oh, you want to. There, get rid of that delay. Okay. Cool. All right, so the first Z is 9. That's better. Test ain't gonna be valid though. Next Z is gonna be like, yeah, 91. I think there's actually a 90 though. Not first extra, num extra times. 0 plus extra should have been 0. Yeah, I is 1, that would have been 0. Alright, so I guess this is 91. So anyways, we should hit a breakpoint here. Nice, yeah, it found it at 98. Cool. So we should be able to let it do this now. Cool, yeah, alright, we got a segue back to this area. Okay, good. I'm glad that works. I guess I should make sure the other one works too. All right. Whoa, this one's broken. Oops. Okay, that one's totally broken. I'm gonna fix it later. Wait, was that just something really simple? See what happens the second time, actually. Yeah, okay, it does. Okay, so back to this room. Okay, so now we just need the lightning boss to do her thing inside this room, depending on the ending variable. I'm trying to remember how I did that other one. The other one had her. I think she was a foe on that screen already. So she was lightning boss, not two. Here, Stealer, this is the one. Okay, so I guess we'll call her the lightning boss giver. Okay, so we got close that. Where is she gonna be? Oh, right, we'll need to add this to foes. Something like. Ah, should be the same place, I guess. Okay, so now it's up to the lightning boss giver. To appear at the right time. How did that happen for the other one? Visible zero. Just, I didn't set something. Oh, that's how it works. It checks the quantity of the ship fall. Oh, that's cool. That works. So if quantity ending is one, that's how she triggers. So she goes into mode zero where she appears, does the stealing animation, shaking, disappearing. It's gonna be kind of similar. Similar stuff. See if we can fade out the music too before all this. Is there an action fade? Okay, so if we have more than one word, more than if we have at least one word, and it's fade, then we've just fade out the music system. Okay, this is starting to come along. Wonder why this other cutscene's not working though. It's just trying to run it right away. Why are these triggering so early? This is probably why it's messing up, because it goes out of its paused state. I think this is what's wrong with both this segue and the other segue. Let's confirm that. I go to this segue. Thank you. Wow, okay. So this is kind of a bigger bug. Okay, well, I'm aware of this bug. I know exactly what's happening. Has to do with the flux segue thing here. So let's put it back how it was. But I'll leave this here so I know to deal with this later. So I can go back to what I was doing, working here on the lightning boss appearing and giving her energy to this other brain, bringing it back to life. Okay, so she needs to warp in. Let's ignore story verbosity. Just focus on the artwork here. So let's get that opened up. Okay, that's how she appears. What's up, Diamond Killer? Howdy! Welcome to today's stream. So she needs like a peer. She needs to start with her steel animation, basically. Skin steel. Animate appear. So she should have appear dash steel. Oh. Here. There we go. Now she's got an appear steel. So yeah, she can appear now. And she should be able to idle with the steel as well. And we need to get it so she does a new animation. So she's got this steel animation. There's a pure steel. She also has the thing where she's breaking into the glass from your ship. Yeah, so this animation. So it would kind of be in reverse. Pushing onward, nice. Good ear. So yeah, if this just animates in reverse, she can kind of give her energy back to it's basically this whole thing in reverse. Dang, let's just play that in reverse. Dang. All right, so that's that one's steel. We want it to just be. We'll just call this one give. And it's just steel in reverse. Okay, now when she appears, she does her steel thing. Oh, she can set it at her position as well. There's if position, there's set position, there's individual X, Y, Z. So she, if it has stir val one, I guess, so it would be position. Okay, so we'll parse e dot position. Set from stir val one. And also apply ground. Okay, so now the Lightning Boss Giver can set her own position, which means that AI creation doesn't need to worry about that anymore. Area creation. So get rid of all that. What's up, Grim Gary? Spoilers! Spoilers today. Working on final cutscenes today. This is so sweet. Almost to have this game to the point where it's like almost finished. Almost, actually. Okay, so since she can set her own position, we want to set it so she's going to be feeding the left brain in this scene. So she needs to be at like. Oh. There's like an area position for this. DLC time. Yeah, I know, right? As soon as it's out, I'll be like, oh, there's so much more. There's gonna be so much more to do. There probably will be. Is it, if it's successful, I'll definitely be adding mini bosses. And the only question will be, should it be a free DLC or like free updates, or should it actually be a paid DLC? It'll all depend on how much content, I guess, there is. We'll see. You want the $5 skin DLC? Okay, I know there's this function for this. It's called parse. Yeah, parse position, that's it. Female Jib, yeah. It would be nice if this function also knew how to put something on the ground. Why not? Let's do this. If contains, what was it, stir? Pause.z is. Actually, this might as well just be baked into this. Else if word equals ground. I equals two. And word is ground. Pause.z equals this get tile max z given the rest of the pause. There, so parse positions to be smart enough to pa like parse its last parameter as ground, which means now we can just parse position straight to stir val one and not worry about any of this. And I'll definitely need to see that in action. All right, so let's go to the AI and now set the position how we want it, which is like five B, maybe more like six B. Right? Yeah. If it's the right price, if it's the right. They're all $2. Yeah, totally. Third of the game's price. That's what I was thinking. Especially if there's a lot more story and content added. Yeah, it would be worth it, a whole DLC, I think, for that. Let's put her at 90 ground. There, so let's see if that works. We can control her position with her AI. Oh, probably need to put in a squiggly mark there. No, wait. Why didn't that work? This didn't happen. Okay, that's the problem. Oh, she needs a move component as well. She should have a move component. Yeah. Oh, it's turbo zero. That explains it. Okay, so now we should hit this breakpoint. Good. Three words, they got parsed correctly. Oops. Well, I just did it all without walking through it, but so let's see if it okay, I put it at negative 1950. That's not right. 5B should have been more than that. Was only five total. Dang, it did not even use the B part. Oh, because we're not even using that part of the function. Dang, I didn't know this. There's another function. It's like parse position, but it parses the block size. Is that it? Oh, constants parse block size. Okay, so it starts by parsing it as stir pause. What was parse position used for? Well, just that. There's spawn. Okay, so we'll do it like is block if contains stir, if any of the stir has a B, then it's probably has a block size. There we go, if it doesn't have a block. Well, actually, we want to check if the current word has a block. Okay, so there. Now it should parse out a regular integer or whatever is fine. Or if it has a B, it'll use the word or the block size. Oh, that's also S dot back. It's called word dot back. That's cool. Okay, I think that's pretty good. Just make sure it works. So it is a block. There, now it's working. And now the only thing it should change here is this bit. Yeah, so it's got ground at the end, so this should become whatever the ground height is, which is -3. Good. Aha, good. She's over about 5B, so she needs to be more like 7. Yeah, I'm glad this is working. What's up, Rocket Bunny? What's up, HD? Burning holes in your retina? Yeah, I'm working on the ending cutscenes here, final cutscenes. What's up, y'all? Oh, HD, you will be happy to note I started watching Dragon Ball Z. So, I've only seen one episode of Dragon Ball Z so far. Am I still a good person if I hate Gohan already? Dragon Ball Z. Dragon Ball Z, that's so funny. Gotta speak the Queen's English, huh? Not here. This is America, man. Speak how I want. Yeah, so totally. Yeah, I hope the next episode doesn't have as much Gohan, but I bet you it probably there's plenty of Gohan, I'm sure. Really? Yeah, I'm thinking maybe like by season 2 Gohan's going to be like, I'll be like, "Oh, cool." Gohan's like, okay, now Gohan's better. Or maybe he's like turns into a little warrior or something. He's not as much of a little whatever the hell you call him. But yeah, Goku's really cool. And so is the enemy guy. I forget the enemy's name or whatever. He's so cool. He's like, your power level is so low. It's only 321. I love it. Yeah, Rocket Bunny, he's like this little crybaby, basically. He's very crybaby-ish. It took you 5 attempts? Yeah. I hear there's some really epic parts to all of it, so I'm really excited. It's over 9,000! I can't wait for that part, too. I mean, that's gonna be like really exciting to finally see that. All right. So this animation she's doing is the wrong one. We wanted to give, not steal. And she needs to start a little bit more this way, so she's like R7, and she needs to be flipped. Oh wait, now she could just face to the right or the left. Face west. English dubbing? And whatever I watched, it didn't have any dubbing. Yeah, I can't. I love the friggin' fight scenes. They're so sweet. You've never watched Dragon Ball Z? Wait a minute, Rocket Bunny. Wait a minute, Rocket Bunny. You're so young. Like, you came out before you. It came out before you came out. Let's just say that. It came out before you were born. So you weren't even born when Dragon Ball Z started. And so many great classic games were created before you were born. In fact, Rocket Bunny, have you played Super Metroid? Yeah, you've never played Super Metroid? Like, okay, what do you have planned tonight? Right. The original's great too, but like Super Metroid is like a classic game that everyone who considers themselves a gamer, it's like a must play. You're gonna practice Dutch tonight? Nice one. Nice one. School stuff? Nope, you can cancel it, man. Wait, it's Monday. I can't just tell you to cancel school. It's on a Monday. Okay, man, all I'm saying is you really need to take a moment when you can. The next time you have a free hour, start playing Super Metroid. Promise you, it's gonna be so worth it. You're gonna be like, what? I didn't even know this was so off. Make sure you get a controller. You have a nice controller. Whatever, an Xbox controller or whatever. Okay, so let's see if that worked when she's facing west now. Okay, she almost did it, but she faced east. Why is she? Oh, she probably has a face east right here. Ah. All right. Let's make it a little clearer there. No, it's not a big robot suit. It's a regular human-sized robot suit, sort of. Okay, that almost worked. So when she gives a anime give and then it doesn't do the sound steal. Doesn't rumble. But then it gets skin nothing. You ever get that feeling when you just ate lunch and then you're already hungry? Got that feeling right now. Whoops, she just totally went crazy weird there. Oh, I think she needs skin. Skin visible, that's right. Skin visible. That happens all the time? Yeah, right? I got that right now, man. I just had a proper, good, nice lunch. You too, dummy? Like, I swear, I ate like 45 minutes ago. That's it. I feel like I already eaten dinner. It's every time you have Chinese food, yeah? Wait, you never get hungry? Okay, so she's also gonna need to bring alive the whole. So they need to set target and then set target mode. So once the steel's done, skin visible. No, wait, this is right when it shakes. So if screen shake. So we wanna go set target named brain L. So the brains need some names. These name these brains need names. Name brain R. There we go. Rocket's a robot. Oh, so wait, you're never hungry, then you eat, and then you're instantly hungry again. Oh, that's crazy. You never eat breakfast? It's so European of you. I don't know how y'all do that. How you can just like go through the day without breakfast. I'm a breakfast lover. Freaking love breakfast. So hopefully this works. Set target name brain L and then set target mode. No, maybe skin. Set target skin. No, probably just mode. It's easier that way. So the brain L has a. Oh, it's actually it is easier to just do skin. Skin alive. Breakfast was for chumps. HD too. Breakfast is overrated. You guys are funny. You can't eat anything early in the morning? Oh, wow. I'm like the opposite. I have to eat breakfast within 30 minutes of waking up, or I start to get like low blood sugar feeling, like sick to the stomach and like quickly angered. I gotta have breakfast like right away. Okay, let's see. That's not gonna work. So we need set target, behavior target. This is if target. There's set target. All right, so target. Timer speed mode. It's gotta be mode. Where's mode? Yeah, really deep voice. Where's my food? Who's been sleeping in my bed? Okay, we got mask speed, target, our timers. None of these are mode, so we want to set target mode. So behavior is mode and the target is good and number of values set targets mode. It's just an integer. Tea or hot chocolate? Oh, there you go. Nice. Your tea is high risk. Tea is a high risk Move in the morning for you, huh? Right, so just target.ai.mode equals mode. There we go. So now I should be able to set the mode. No. Oh, damn it. I wanted to set skin. Oh well, I'm going to test both of these now. I probably will use that at some point, the whole mode thing. So let's go set target mode one or whatever. Oh, we need to test the targets. If the target even has a freaking. If target dot AI dot empty, not there. Toast and green tea. There you go. Oh, that's cool. I like that. What's up, Bay Siri? Okay, so we've got mode. Let's make sure it works. And then we'll do skin, and then that should make it so that she's able to control the brain's skin, and the brain comes to life when she does her animation. Spoiler alert, I'm working on spoilery things. All right, just needs a little more delay before that happens. A little more time for that segue. How much time is in the other segue? This gives it 10 seconds for the tower brain segue. Yeah, close your eyes. Close your eyes for the whole stream. Keep them closed. Are they still closed? It's just 10 seconds. Well, that wasn't long enough. All right, let's do 15. Blindfolded? There you go. Good. Good. Yeah, they're close. Netherlands. Okay, so a little longer for that. More shake. Wait. More delay before it shakes. Anime give. Oh, because it's in reverse. Anime give is like da 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 da. Wait. Oh, it's gonna be in reverse. That means it goes. Oh, this is 20 frames long, and by she needs to start the animation right about 5 frames, so 15 frames worth, and her steal animation or give is about 10th of a second, so that's 1.5 seconds before she shakes the screen and all that, and her shake should be really, really tiny. Oh, and it should have done the freaking target mode one. Said target name Brain L. Netherlands. 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 We will crush our enemies. Netherlands. No one can stand up against us. Netherlands, y'all are going down. Nobody can play soccer as good as us. Nobody can play American football like Netherlands. We're unstoppable. Nobody can beat the Netherlands. I don't know if the target got named correctly or said correctly. Or maybe the target skin. Oh, that's it. The target skin was first. So this needs to be that next. There. Do a little more time, like that, 20 seconds, and set target mode one, still in heaven. Oh, maybe it needs to be just num values one, target mode one, target, yeah. Maybe just this, I don't know. I don't know. Yes, it's Siri. Yes, it is. It's a behavior tree. It's based on behavior trees. And the data file format I released on GitHub, it's called ValTree. But yeah, so that's a combination of ValTree and a simple scripting language, basically, that works with behavior trees. If you want to look at behavior trees, you know, that's a really great way to do AI because you don't have to recode anything. Once you're, you know, like I don't have to, if I want to change the AI, for example, right here for this lightning girl or whatever that's doing this thing here, I don't have to recompile the game. It's great. And now I have freaking, you know, like 30 or 40,000 lines of data, just data like this and scripts and stuff that does everything in Songbringer. So it's just very compartmentalized. You don't have to recompile things and like, it's just a really rad way to go because, yeah, it separates your data from your, I mean, it separates your, basically just makes it so your AI is not hard-coded. So much more flexible and quick to develop that way. And it keeps your code really organized too. So like, I don't have to write code for all this stuff. I have to write the system for how the code would work. And then I can just let the script do the actual, what a code would do. So anyways, you know what I mean, probably. Hopefully. I'm still wondering why this breakpoint didn't get hit. Target, set, target mode. This is set target, right? Oh no, this is not set. Oh, it's just target named. Target mode, target skin. Okay. This ought to help a little bit. Having the right word. Set target mode, yeah! All right, what are we looking at here? Is the right entity? Yes. What mode is it thinking it will set? Stir val one? No, none of these. It's float val one. No worries. Well, let's just do int mode equals l round f. Float val one. Yeah. How many lines of data are there in Songbringer by now? It's a good question. Boo. Boom! Here you go. Take back this energy. Or take it for the first. Num values. What were you? 2. Num values is 2. Ah, so that wouldn't have worked. All right, good. Could we check that? I can take this off now. Mode is going to be 1. Very good. But it didn't work, but oh well. It didn't have to work. All right, so that now that I coded this thing that I don't even need to use, let me code something I do need to use. Timers. Let's do set targets skin. Target. Let's make sure it does have a render component. Target.render.skin equals stirval1. And just confirming that works too. And we already got skin alive. Target mode 1. Don't need that. There. Oh, did I set a breakpoint? Yeah. All right. Good. Okay, so this will make it so she will actually change the skin of the brain L over there. So as soon as she touches it, boom, it does that. And num values is just 1. Skin. Stirval 1. Target render skin. What was the target's render skin before this? Nothing. Afterwards, should be something. Alive. Cool. That works. All right, and does it do its animation? I don't know. I didn't pay attention. Okay, let's try that again. Well, it did work. That's cool. It's not gray enough then for its brain. Okay, so brain L gray. Yeah, this thing does not end up gray enough. That's better. And then this one, we can turn it on for all these and just make it so it's getting a little less. This is going to be, say, like 70, 40, 10, and then 0. I'm curious about that data. What is the counts here? How many lines of code? 86,000 lines of code already? Just grows every single month. What's the MAME? Maybe. Oh, data count, git count. So lines of data is 27,000. Okay. 27,000 lines of data and scripts. Wow. And number of git commits, 5,700 git commits. Wow. Okay, so target skin alive. Let's see if that looked a little better this time with it. Did I render it out? Shit, I don't even know if I rendered it. Thank you. Still, it's not long enough. Why is it cutting short so fast? 20 seconds, is that short? Might as well do a little screen shake and rumble. This is a 0.6. We want this screen shake to be a little longer, like 3 whole seconds, and very low rumble. That didn't add any time to this whole sequence at all. So something is controlling how this ends. Oh, and maybe it's Faye's cutscene, actually. Somewhere in here, it sets a. Oh no, phase segue. Aha. I guess it would be better if I could set this with data. NM's segue. We could set the flux duration based on a string from the story system. Do I have like a isNumeric method? Oh yeah, I do. Okay, so I can check if the flux string is a numeric string. That looks like this function kind of would work, yeah. Okay, so if it's a numeric flux string, flux duration is the float val. Oh no, parse float flux string. So now the story system can pass in a duration for the flux. And I want to see that. Oh, and when a phase ends, it should reset the flux string. Just to make sure. Whenever a flux ends, it clears out its old flux string. It's probably a good thing to have cleared. Okay. There we go. Okay, so when the anims calls segue, so we call flux set string. If words, if we have at least, all right, so words would be 0 would be segue. 1 would be the pattern you're looking for. And 2 would be the duration of the segue optional. So the words has to be 3 to get words 2. Or else just passing an empty string. Let's make sure that works too. And lastly, going to the story system and now hooking it up so it's just data, we can say anim segue tower brain, however long we want this to be, 15 seconds maybe. Let's do 15, delay 15, and see if it works out just right. All right, words, 3 words, segue, tower brain, 15. So if words the size is greater than or equal to 3, should be, we use words 0, 1, 2, good. So stepping into this method, we should have flux string set string 15, good. And now letting it go, here it's gonna go, oh no, it didn't do, okay, it didn't do it. It didn't do it in story system. This is really weird because it should have hit that totally. All right, man. Oh, cool. Good job, man. Right on. Well, thanks for saying hi, dude. Hope you have a great day. It's good to chat with you. Hopefully I don't hate Gohan as much next time. Just joking. Yeah. Oh, an M segue. Laters. Maybe the set string got messed up there. Aha! Oh, it's doing this other animations, overwriting it. Because it's like triggering that. Okay, so there's still some problems with the whole, yeah. Gosh, I gotta comment that out then for now. This bit right here. So the segue basically doesn't set any delay. There's no delay timer because the segue needs to run things. Needs to be like a smarter segue type or something. There we go. Now phase segue's got it. And it is numeric, so its flux duration was 0.6. That's 15. Good, but I just wanted to. Yeah, nice. Now we got a good delay going there. But I want her to, like, immediately warp away. Yeah, we only need maybe 10 seconds here. Oh, there's a countdown now. Oh, what happened? Okay, maybe that should actually have a little more delay. Before it does this and makes this the brain come alive. Let's try that. So she should feed the brain a little bit, disappear, Then once she's disappeared, the brain comes back to life. Might seem like a little bit better that way. Yeah, and then now it just needs to be a little slower. Which is simple. The brain L. L gray. Let's make it twice as slow. And also I'm thinking, let's try it twice as slow first. But I'm thinking maybe it should have some kind of like bright flashing energy, like it's really come to life. Yeah, that was still kind of fast. Oh, it's not even doing it. It's not even doing this alive animation. No wonder. All right. So we need to make it somehow do alive. Which means it needs a behavior. Oh wow, we haven't done any behaviors in here. Is it possible to do a behavior? Okay, I guess you should put it as part of the behavior or the profile. Okay, so that should trigger it to come alive once it sets its mode to 1. Now I just need to make it. Now I need a story. And now the lightning giver. This is getting confusing. Okay, so target name Brainel, target mode 1. So I did end up using target mode. See if any of its AI even works. Just trying to set it to visible zero as soon as it starts, which means if it's not visible, or if it is visible. Yeah, it's not even doing that AI. Somehow it didn't load it. Okay, so that means that area. Add AI. Okay, so all these are adding AI. Okay, I just want to see this code in action. Oh, for the Brainel. Well, that didn't work. Good, we got this far. So this should be the right profile. Brainel. Let's see what it does with the AI. Does it have a behavior? It should. Children size 1. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, it does have a behavior. New AI component. There, it is doing it. So it's maybe just not triggering it. To start. Oh, run while paused. Might be that. Ew, hopefully it is. Thank you. Yeah, nice. Cool. Okay, so we got run while pause, and we can turn off this sequence. Okay, something crashed. Missing animation, maybe? Brainel animate. Did not like this. What's wrong with that? Oh, we need more words. Right. Animate alive. Zero, not overwritable. Oh, alive might be one of its words. Call this wake. That was super slow. We'll see it at more of a regular speed. And it also needs to go, once it's done, play idle forever. Oops. Didn't go into its idle, unless idle alive. Oh yeah, that should have worked. Should have said skin alive. I guess we could just go mode 2. Nah, that time it was working. All right, this one frame is like a little. Oh, it just needs to be 0.1 seconds there in this animation, that's all. There, that's good. Came to life. Looking good. One thing, the lightning boss giver. I think it should start this a little earlier. Let's rein in. There we go. Very cool. All right, well, that's gonna be it for today's stream. I got that cutscene going, so that's gonna be cool. It's gonna be an instrumental part of the whole plot, where, yeah, that all happens. The brain stuff happens. So, that's cool. It's one part of the ending finished. Yeah, Clone Geek, you too. Have a good night. Thanks for watching, everybody. Appreciate you.